Hi, today teardown of this box. So as you can see, it is a gray box. I believe it is an autopilot processing unit for Russian aircraft. What do we have? We have a shock absorbing mount with this gray box mounted on this. Here is how deep it is, 20 centimeters. There is here the model and serial number. We will zoom on it later. On the front, just an access panel with two plugs. Multi-pin plugs with silver-coated contacts, it seems, for this one. With original, well, workshop original, I should say, covers on the plugs. This one is a little tight. This one is a female one. Okay. Grounding strap here. And here mounting screw to remove from the bracket. The top cover is a little bit worn out, as you can see. Lots of dents in it. But, well, I'll got this item like this. But the insides are really beautiful and interesting, so I will not complain too much, I guess. So I will remove it from this shock absorber mount. So there is one bolt to undo here. It will release this leg in here, and now I should be able to. It is in fact pretty difficult, but it should slide off. This time I have problems with this thing to remove it. For some reason, here we are. So, the shock absorber mount and the box itself. So we have one top cover, one main frame unit, and one bottom cover, which we will remove like right now after I install the camera in the overhead position. So here we are. Here you have a view of the top cover to see the exact condition it is. So first we will have a look at this mounting thing. Very generic, with locating pins. We have a plate here with a model and serial number of the device. And we have the four mounting fits. So they are made with these two aluminium pieces. Inside we have rubber and a spring. And all together it makes a shock absorber. The screw here to secure the device with some ring at the back so you cannot remove it completely, and a conical shape here to fit perfectly the mounting piece. For some reason they did put some yellow paint over the screws and over the rivets here. And here also for the grounding strap, but not here. Even for the rivets of the manufacturer plate, but not for the rivets of these locating pins. It is quite odd. There is yellow paint here also, some remains. Okay. So, about this box now. In fact, I have a few screws to remove around to reveal the top part, but we will keep it for later, and I will start with the bottom panel. Okay. So here you have two smaller screws which were covered by some seal, factory seal. It has been broken a long time ago. You can see they are very tiny screws. So they are just really for sealing purpose. And the plate is now loose. And here is what we have inside. So as you can see, so first about this panel, there is some kind of yellow coating over the metal inside, but there is also, for some reason, a lot of scratches in it. I did not make them. I do not know how it did happen. It is quite weird. So we have this big PCB, well, terminal board, not really a PCB, with a whole bunch of wires all the way, and this hose to accommodate green tantalum capacitors. I will zoom in on it for you before I try to remove this PCB. As you can see, big wire harnesses coming from the plugs here, and interconnecting a whole bunch of stuff. The cables are wrapped in this blue tape, as usual, in fact. We have all the solders with some green paint or lacquer on them. And you can see here we have a little lacing to keep everything in place, neat and tidy. Really, really amazing work. So I will remove the screws that are securing this panel in place. So each time we have one screw, one shockproof washer. So the most interesting part is will be the other side of the box, because we have some very fancy design in it. But sadly, we will not see a lot of stuff at this other side, because in fact, it is a whole bunch of potted modules, very beautiful potted modules, but potted, so it does not allow to see much. If I remember correctly, there is a bunch of potentiometers on the front to allow adjustments. So there is quite a few screws to undo here. Should be good. And now I just need to try to fit this board across the pattern here. It is coming off, yes. So, what do we have on the board first? So, as I said, we have a bunch of green capacitors, and you can see we have also a whole army of relays. Relays. Some metal body diodes here with heat-shrink tubing around them. You can see how they did secure in place these green capacitors with at each time a dual piece of wire and heat-shrink. So they are really, really well secured in place. I see smaller parts here, probably diodes, which are glued to the PCB, well, to the board. And it is more or less all for this board, in fact. Very beautiful and fancy. Very clean, also. No dust or anything. But I cannot say the same thing about this side of the box. So here we have wires going to the modules at the other side. you can see there is a bunch of terminals, screws for securing whatever is on the other side, standoffs for the board, and this big wire harness. Some thicker wires here for some reason. Trim pot here, potentiometer. And all the big wire mess going to the connectors. And you can see how they did wrap the wires together. But I see something not terribly good here. I will try to zoom in for you. Will you see it, guys? Look at this. Here exactly we have what seems to be some mold. It's quite weird. Maybe here also over this piece of cable lacing. So it may be an issue with moisture, in fact, in my garage where this item is stored. So I will try to clean it a little bit at least before I reassemble it. So here is for this bottom piece. Very, very interesting. Let me see if I can get some drawers or anything quickly. No. Of course, it is only need, you don't find. No. So, I will clean this, reassemble this PCB, and I will be right back to check what we have at the other side. Okay, before I undo the top cover, a little look at the plate here. We have the model number, serial free. And an impressively long serial number. Usually the serial numbers for Soviet stuff are 4 or 5 digits long. But here, it is quite impressive. So I do not know if we have a date code hidden somewhere in this. Okay, now for the good stuff, because of course, in fact, all what we did see previously under the bottom panel were auxiliary parts, but the real business is in the top side, because we have some kind of brains inside this. Are you ready, guys, for the big reveal? If I did not forget a screw, yes, I did totally forget screws. Seems the screws for the access panel on the front are also securing the top cover. It should work better now. Yes, maybe, not sure. Yes, but the screw is quite annoying and preventing it to move. Maybe now it is okay. Yes, and here is the deal, guys. We have a whole bunch of these modules which are completely potted in hard coating, so no way we know what there is inside. First, on the front, we have a whole bunch of trim pots here, potentiometers, to adjust things, probably, with their resistor number inside the circuit. R2, R4, you can see there is no R1, so R1 is somewhere else. And there is some kind of locking a brake mechanism, so it cannot turn very easily, in fact. And you can hear it is clicking when I turn it. So yes, there is a little spring, and you can see there is this these grooves in the knob in front of the potential metal shaft, and there is a little piece of metal spring at the back prevent hitting it to turn. So can I zoom it a little bit for you? So you can see there is one more PCB here with a bunch of resistors at the back here. Where is it? Here. And the regular Gaussian potentiometers with Amberton casing. But these nice features in the front to keep them in place, and also you have a red indicator, as you can see here, to indicate more or less the level of the potentiometers. So, but about now these things. We have a whole bunch of these boxes. Each one has a model and a serial number. So these do all seem to be the same model number, in fact. As you can see, this part number. I'm trying to adjust my display, okay. This part number. And the serial number are not very far, one from another. So we have 10 of them, and 3 of different models. So serial number 73 may be the year. This one is ending by 30270. Here we have 30298, 31918, 30100. 655, 885. Quite well, they are not immediately following one another. And here we have three other boxes of different kinds. It seems we have here, maybe it is a trim pot. Little screw poking out. Yes, it is a trim pot. So you can adjust something in here. On the front of these boxes, we have screws. Well, holes for probably for mounting screws, because you can maybe mount them in an other way. And you can see where the patterns you have in the material, in the potting material. I do not know what it is made with, but it is really weird. In real life, it is the color of milk, coffee, something like this. But we have darker parts inside, which seems to be of a different material. So I do not know if it was made from recycled stuff or something like this. Very, very tiny bubbles, air bubbles in the surface. And a whole bunch of quality control stamps. As you can see, so this one, for some reason, is a very different finish than the other ones. This one is really soft finish. This one is quite rough, and this one is shiny, not this one. It is interesting. Here we have more weirdness, because we have totally a different mix of colors, with a lot lighter color here, dark corner here. Here we have, looks like some another material, really interesting. I can see in these modules here, we have two mounting holes on the side. So in fact, they are mounted by the at the bottom side, you did so four screws each time for each one, and one or two strips of terminal contacts, securing all the things in place. So if I had the possibility to X-ray, all of them, it would be nice. Because I have no clue of how it is made inside, but I did do a teardown not a long time ago from another American-made module, which was quite interesting. But this one I cannot destroy them, sadly. Here, all at the bottom, we have a potentiometer. We did see the body off at the bottom side. For interesting something, but I did notice four thicker wires arriving here at the other side, but I do not know what they are going, where they are going in this side of the thing. And really, really, really impressive finish. It was quite a surprise when I did receive this box, in fact, and open it for the first time, because really, I was not expecting to find this at all. And it was quite a neat discovery. And it looks like my white balance is a little bit messed up. Yes, maybe I will adjust it in the YouTube processing. Okay, so I guess it is all for this thing, because there is not a lot more to see, but it is a real nice piece. In fact, it could go on display with removing the top cover, which is damaged. You keep it on the base and it could make a nice display, because it is quite cool to look at all these fancy modules. So they are sealed for protection of secrets inside, maybe. Because we must have some fancy signal processing or something like this. Or servo controls or anything like this. And probably they were quite proud of this design and did not want it to be copied. Or we have very delicate parts that mean to be insulated for the external conditions. Not sure, but it was quite a discovery, this fact for sure. This thing for sure. So, thanks for watching. Bye bye.